Hey guys, my name is Miska and welcome to Overwatch Central. Today we're going to be taking a look at some quick news regarding the game, some things around Overwatch, and just general things going on in the community that I thought you guys might be interested in. I'm actually moving this week, so it's a bit hectic for me, but I'm going to try to get through all of these things pretty quickly. So let's get started straight away. Mystery Deathmatch, a new mode that has been added to the arcade. It is now available, I believe, on every platform. It was pushed last night, it seems like. And it is pretty much what you expect it to be. This has been requested in the community for quite a while, actually. I remember seeing a post suggesting this not too long ago. And it is pretty much what you expect it to be, just from the name, obviously. It's normal deathmatch, so the 8-player FFA mode. But every time you die, you respawn as a new hero. Now, the obviously problematic thing there is that you lose your ultimate, so you kind of want to be using your ult as fast as you possibly can. And also, if you get some here that's not too ideal for the mode, then that's not great. But it is there to create some randomness and just give people a bit of a fresh mode to play. So if you want to check that out, go to the arcade and play that. You can, of course, get wins in this mode that count towards the normal arcade weekly rewards, all the loot boxes and stuff. Good stuff for those of you that like the arcade and play a lot of that. Next up, there's a new Zarya skin, but unfortunately not in Overwatch. And I feel like the trend of Zarya skins that look really good but are in other Blizzard games continues, as Heroes of the Storm have done it once again and created a really good looking Zarya skin. We don't really see these types of Zarya skins or skins at all, honestly, in Overwatch. But yeah, Zarya has a really cool new looking skin, the Phantom Knight Zarya. And like I said, this is in Heroes of the Storm, so it's kind of for the Heroes of the Storm Halloween event, I believe. And speaking of which, the Overwatch Halloween event is really not too far away now. But yeah, this one is in HOTS, of course. It's from the trailer, I'll link it down below. But yeah, play Overwatch team, hopefully we get some cool Zarya skins in actual Overwatch as well. We have some, but I would love to see more. Something people have been talking about and complaining about, I guess, for quite a long time. But yeah, I thought I'd show you guys that. Next up, a little bit more sort of competitive Overwatch related. Not necessarily Overwatch League, but more contenders. And it has to do with Defran. A lot of people know Defran as a streamer who has been streaming all sorts of different games, but primarily Overwatch, of course. Used to play competitively way back in the day. That's in the Overwatch competitive esports scene, not just on ladder, of course. And has been talking a lot about Overwatch League and how he hasn't been interested in it for a while, but recently, it seems like Defran is actually looking to potentially return to the professional scene, according to this tweet from Halo here. He'd be playing at Contenders level, or possibly with Atlanta. There was then an additional tweet here as well. Obviously, a lot of people talking about this, as Defran has just been one of the biggest Overwatch streamers for quite a while. Very well known in the community for a lot of different things. But more recently, a lot of people have been wanting him to make a return to competitive Overwatch, to play at pretty much the highest level. He's a very good hitscan player, Tracer, Soldier, all that sort of stuff. More recently, Torbjörn too. So this news hitting about Defran has been pretty big to a lot of people. This has then been speculated about and almost further confirmed that Defran is at least reaching out to Academy teams. So yeah, we'll see exactly what happens there and to what extent he's actually reached out to teams, because it could be a thing of just asking a friend or two here and there versus really dedicating to it. It's hard to know before anything really settles and it's actually announced. But yeah, thought I'd let you guys know. Thought that was some interesting news that you guys might be interested in. And last but absolutely not least, Overwatch Central. This channel is actually coming up to its 3-year anniversary. I believe it's on the 27th of September or something like that the channel was actually created. Maybe even before then. But the first proper video with gameplay and such was uploaded on the 5th of October. So yeah, coming up to 3 years very soon. Thank you guys very much for all of the support. It's been great doing this for such a long time. Obviously, right at the start, it was mostly just a hobby and a very small thing. All the way up until release, it was actually a pretty small channel, but with a very dedicated audience. So we definitely appreciate all of you for that. But of course, we're quite a lot of people on here nowadays. Thank you guys very much. And that is all for this quick news video. If in the next week or two, you see a bit more of Ryan than me on the channel, then that might just be because I am moving currently and just have a lot of things to sort out, a lot of things to do. I don't even have a proper PC right now, I'm just on a laptop actually. But yeah, I thought I'd make you guys aware, since sometimes people tend to ask, hey, what's going on? A lot of Ryan videos lately, or a lot of just Miska videos lately, can you guys do more videos together? Thought I'd give you guys a heads up there. Alright, thank you very much once again. Subscribe for more Overwatch content, you guys know the drill. Until next time, take care, and we'll see you then.